Graham hit Derek, and then Durante hit Graham for hitting Derek, and then Graham hit Durante, and then Derek hit Shunas for hitting Durante, and the two of them are ganging up, and he says, "Oh, come on, the two of you, that'll do them way, you know." And I played in that game. I remember that game vividly on a Friday morning, and they were just smacking into each other, and the respect that Walter Smith had from everybody. I'd never seen an assistant manager stop a training session before. And Walter just went, blew the whistle. And he went over, and whoever had the ball at their feet, he just stamped. He says, "Give us it." And he picked the ball up. He says, "Right." And he's go, "All these, get in."
This is Ibrox.
Quite interested, Jimmy, just in terms of, so spoken about, you know, the change in ownership, you've got Souness in there, you've got the new players coming in, you've got Morris Johnston, all that kind of stuff happening around the club. What was it like to be at the heart of the club where, particularly in that period, Rangers were the only story in town, and it was a total revolution that was impacting every part of Scottish society and every part of Scottish football. What was it like to be living that day to day?
Well, it was great to see, you know, listen, the most important thing about football is playing with good players. You know, don't forget, I was bottom of the league with Sunderland. I was McCoy's fault. And I was bottom of the league with West Brom. And see, when you're bottom of the league, and I've got a wee bit of everything, and you're Northern Ireland where you're trying to do your best, but you always feel up against it. And see, if you, all these different clubs you've been to, you really appreciate when you go to a club where you've got good players. You know, and not just the Butchers and the Woods and these boys and all the Saints, that Davy Cooper's still up. Davy, yeah. And Coysty and all these boys. So they had a good blend of the ones you brought in, top, top players, and the ones who appreciated what was happening at the club. The ones that had been there for years and appreciated the change. Oh, listen, it's not going to be a struggle now. Hopefully we're going to win more games than lose. Hopefully we'll win things. Because the worst feeling in the world is having a career and not winning anything. And these, so everybody must have thought, right, okay, you have a chance of doing something here. Because their quality on the pitch. And Graham would play himself, of course. Young lads were coming through, Durant, Derek Ferguson, then you could see him for Ray Wilkins, and just, yeah. Everything was just, it was a joy to go into work every day, because you had the sense of humour of the Scotch boys, McCoy and Durant, and then you had the English boys.
I can imagine.
The gin and tonic boys and the paint the tenants boys, you know.
Is it true that you used to play them against each other in training? You play the Scottish team and the English team? That.
Oh, geez, I was there. I mean, it was only recently I heard Ian John and Derek Ferguson talking about it. The day that Souness, I can't remember how it went, but Graham hit Derek. And then Durante hit Graham for hitting Derek. And then Graham hit Durante. And then Derek hit Souness for hitting Durante. And the two of them are ganging up. And he says, "Oh, come on, the two of you, that'll do them way, you know." And I played in that game. I remember that game vividly on a Friday morning. And they were just smacking into each other. And the respect that Walter Smith had from everybody. I'd never seen an assistant manager stop a training session before. And Walter just went, blew the whistle. And he went over, and whoever had the ball at their feet, he just stamped. He says, "Give us it." And he picked the ball up. He says, "Right." And he's go, "All these, get in. It's going too far. It's a Friday morning." Finished. And he stopped the training session, Walter, before it got out of hand. You know, so. But they were, I mean, great, great days. You had a great blend, a great mix. Because all the young ones all respected Wilkins and Butch and all. And they respected the job that the Scottish boys could do, you know.
Jimmy, when Souness brought in Gary Stevens, and your game time maybe looked like it was going to be a bit more limited, and you moved to look after some of the reserves with John McGregor, who were you looking after at that stage? Who was in the pool of guys at that point?
Oh, that was Big Nizzy and Gus McPherson and Gary McSwiggin, John Spencer.
Excellent.
All them kids. I mean, I loved it. Used to give them wee games and quizzes and all, and then wee John Spencer. I made the mistake one day. I think Koisty was injured, and somebody said, there's only one striker. There's only one striker. And I made the mistake of saying to Gary McSwiggan and John Spencer, one of you's got a wee chance this week. Because them days used to play reserve games on a Saturday.
Yeah.
I said, one of you's still got a wee chance to play this week. My mother said to me, Jimmy, keep an eye on the two of them in case we use one on this weekend. And I made the mistake of telling them. You know, so they were just all week, but the two of them were flying. My mother says, what do you think? I said, well, if you want McSwiggan's pace, McSwiggan. If you want Spencer's brain, Spencer. Anyway, it's up to you. So I went in there Friday morning into the office, and the phone goes. I said, Jimmy, bring up them pair of boots. Bring them upstairs. And I brought a pair of boots up, and Andy Gray was sitting there. And he says, Jimmy, do you know Andy? I says, I play again. I says, how are you doing? All right. What are you doing here? The game's not done, are they? He said, we've signed Andy till the end of the season. And such was the importance of having to win every game of football that we couldn't even take a chance.
Yeah.
Okay, McSwiggan or John Spencer. And that's the pressure, if you want to call it pressure, but it was a wee indication to me the pressure at Graham and Walder in order to win games of football, to win leagues, to do things. You know, because Graham said, hey, what's up with you on a Monday? What's up? Ah, we'll beat 2-3-0 and all this carry on. And if we got beaten on Saturday, it was a wee bit. Walder was good at picking me up, you know. But I was always concerned about the young lads. And it would turn out, I tell you what, I've got 3 or 4 cracking lads.
Yeah.
You'll be able to look forward to in the future. He said, and Graham said, tell me, I'll never be able to play 3 or 4 young lads in the team. If you get me one a year and be exceptional, like Durant and Cooper, they've got to be exceptional. I'll never get 3 or 4 kids into this team. Give me one a year and I'll be happy.